Yes, Mr. Manning?
Yeah, little Dicky Bird whispered to me that you're trying to extend your sentence on purpose. Is that right?
Oh, I wouldn't do anything like that. That'd be real stupid, wouldn't it?
Bloody stupid, Bernsie. Too stupid for me to have anything to do with. All right?
Right, Mr. Manning.
Listen, whatever your feelings, you and Keane are going to be together here until your trial. Now, the best thing you can do is stay out of any situation that could damage your case, right?
Won't be easy.
Well, you'll have Joey with you. You concentrate on him and leave everything else to the courts, all right?
Fellas, what you did.
And what do you want?
He's put it to me loud and clear. It's either you or me.
Oh, I don't see the point. You're not going to be in here for much longer.
But you never can tell, Mrs. M. When I was in here the last time, I got extra sentences all the time.
Well, if you stay out of trouble, Doreen, you won't have that worry, will you?
Doesn't seem I have much option. I love your frock.
Thank you, Doreen. Now just join the queue, will you?
I'm beginning to think that it's easier to get out of this place than it is to stay in it.
Well, if you'd rather sit on your own.
Oh, all right, don't just sit.
Anything wrong?
It's my daughter's 16th birthday. I'd like to be with her, that's all.
What do you reckon, Myra? About what?
I was just telling Dor here that she should tell this Hans creep that he doesn't turn her on or give in and marry her.
I told you before, Helen, I'm not the marrying kind. Not anymore, anyway, so just give it a rest, will you?
Hey, how do you reckon the women would react to forming a prisoner's union?
A union? What for?
Oh, better paying conditions, modern machinery, that sort of stuff.
And what if the department doesn't come to the party? Do we go on strike?
Well, we tried that before and all we get is loss of privileges.
That's right. If you try and hold out, they just extend your sentence.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no. In my big mouth.
Happy birthday, Brett.
Oh, I thought you'd forgotten. Oh,
fat chance of that. You've been dropping hints for weeks. Well, come on, open it.
Oh, Alan, it's terrific. You shouldn't have spent that much.
How do you know how much it cost? I thought you might like to wear it tonight. You going out to celebrate?
No. I'm not.
Why not? I thought you planned out
It's been put off due to lack of interest. My friends have gone a bit cold on me since Mum went to prison.
Yeah. Been the same with me at work. I was up for that promotion, but now that all this has happened, I guess I'll be lucky to have a job at all. Still, it'll all blow over soon. We'll get by.
Yeah. Oh, I gotta go. Thanks again for the present. Well, listen, I might be a bit late this afternoon.
Oh, where are you going?
Might walk around a bit, have a look at a few shops.
You're not going to see Gloria, are you?
Maybe I'll drop in for a minute.
Listen, Brett, I know it's your day, but if you want to go out and visit someone, why don't you go and see Mum? It'd be nice for her, seeing as it's your birthday.
Yeah, I might do that. I've got sports period this afternoon. I could give it a miss.
Good. It'd mean a lot to her.
Okay, see you later.
Hey.
Thanks.
For a start, you will unload your equipment at the rear of the prison. I don't want this reception area cluttered up with this stuff.
Right, Ian?
Right, Bert.
This is just bits and pieces. The rest of the stuff's out in the ute.
All your equipment will be itemised and accounted for when you leave.
Right. Right, Ian?
Oh, right, Bert.
Your equipment and vehicle will be inspected on arrival and departure, just to make sure that nothing's smuggled in or out. Is that clear?
You're going to be the lucky one to inspect my equipment?
Save the charm, Mr. Gibbs. We've got enough would-be clowns in this place.
Good morning.
Oh, good morning, Governor. These are the men to install the PA system.
Oh, good. How long do you think it'll take? Oh,
I'm not too sure. The plans I saw are in a bit of a mess.
Well, come through to my office and I'll show you what I had in mind. Miss Ferguson will brief you on security procedure.
She already has.
I haven't finished yet, Governor.
Oh.
Well, bring them through when you have, would you?
Yes, Governor. One more thing. There will be no contact whatsoever with any of the women prisoners. Right, Ian?
Right, but... Yeah, right.
Good. Now, if you sign the book, gentlemen, I shall take you through.
Hey, your card's right and you can have it, right?
Wrong.
Mrs. Powell?
Yes?
I'm Detective Birmingham. This is Detective Mears. Could we have a few words with you?
Come in. Is this concerning my family?
Well, indirectly, yes.
I thought Inspector Clark was handling the case.
Yes, he is, but we're on the case too.
I see.
We understand how you must be feeling, Mrs. Powell, so we'll keep this as short as possible.
Thank you.
Naturally, we're following the line that the bomb was meant for Rick Manning and not for your family. Oh,
that is fairly obvious.
Would you have any idea of anyone who might want to kill Manning?
No, I wouldn't. I only work with him, so why don't you ask him?
Do you know of any association between Manning and Senior Detective Eddie Stevens?
Eddie Stevens?
Yes, do you know if they've seen each other lately?
No, I don't know whether they've seen each other lately. What has this got to do with anything?
We're pretty sure that Rick Manning is getting himself involved in things that are none of his business. Very dangerous things.
This is really unofficial, Mrs. Powell. But as a friend, it might be wise to warn him, don't you think? It might stop any more innocent people from getting hurt.
Thanks for your time, Mrs. Powell. We'll see ourselves out.
Don't just stand there. Give him a hand.
Excuse me, Inspector. Is the driver okay?
G'day, Ron. No, I'm afraid he's dead.
Any suspicious circumstances?
No, just another straightforward accident. Won't know until the car's been examined, of course, but it looks like brake failure to me.
Any identification?
Yeah, but it's not for print yet. Not until it's cleared. It's one of our boys. Stevens. Senior Detective Eddie Stevens.
Colin, you haven't been rostered back on duty yet, have you?
I just wanted to see if these fitted.
Yes, they're quite smart, aren't they?
Do you have a minute?
Yes, of course. I'd like a coffee?
No, thank you. I'd like to come back. If that's all right with you.
Well, I don't know. I mean,
I
don't
know
you think
we've had our problems, but I'm going mad hanging around Meg's flat with nothing to do. Look, if you don't want me working back here, then please, could you just say so, because I'll have to look for something else.
Colin, please. All I'm worried about is whether you're well enough, that's all.
Couldn't I come back part-time, just a few hours a day? I'd be all right. I'd rather...
All right, then. I'll have you rostered on tomorrow. Is that all right?
Yeah, that's fine. Thank you.
Good. Sure you won't have one?
No, thanks.
Colin, how are you?
A lot better, thank you.
Good.
By the way, I had a visit from two detectives this morning. They appear to be rather worried about you.
Oh, what were their names?
Birmingham was one of them, I think.
What did they want?
They seem to think that you need some good advice about minding your own business, whatever that means.